Dear students, in this video, we are discussing about tautomerism. The topic is not given in NCERT textbook, but you should know at least fundamental factors about tautomerism. Tautomerism, that is a type of functional isomerism. So functional group will be different in case of tautomers. Tautomers are isomers showing tautomerism. What are tautomers? This is not a normal isomer. If you take a sample of a compound, it contains a lot of molecules. In those molecules, some molecules will be in another form. That is, a compound exists in two different interconvertible structures. Two forms can be interconverted. Okay. You just imagine a classroom. All the students are facing a teacher. One student is sitting in the class in such a way that he faces the back side of the class. If the teacher corrects that student, another student turns back. In that manner, molecules are converting into another form. Okay? A dynamic equilibrium between two structures. That is why this isomerism is also known as dynamic isomerism. There will be an equilibrium between these two tautomeric forms. Okay? Desmotropism or allelotropism, all these are the other names of tautomerism. Normally, tautomerism shown by the compounds containing the functional group with multiple bonds like C double bond O, C triple bond EN, like that. Okay. Normally, we are discussing aldehydes, ketones, cyanides, etc. Now, listen here. What are the conditions for tautomerism? The fundamental condition is nothing but presence of labile hydrogen. What is labile hydrogen? That is alpha hydrogen. We have discussed already alpha carbon, alpha hydrogen, etc. So alpha hydrogen on sp3 carbon, singly bonded carbon. But that sp3 carbon should not be bridged alpha carbon. Now, what is alpha hydrogen? Alpha hydrogen is nothing but acidic hydrogen. We will give examples, then you can understand very clearly. This is acetaldehyde, you know, that is CH3CHO. This is acetaldehyde. Okay, acetaldehyde is converted into this compound. There is a double bond and OH group. That is why this form is known as enol form. Enol form. This contains a C double bond O group. That is why this form is known as keto form. So keto enol tautomerism is the simplest tautomerism. This compound contains aldehyde group and this compound contains hydroxyl group and double bond. So functional groups are different. That is why we said this is one type of functional isomerism. Now listen here, what is happening in this case? You know, oxygen is electronegative than carbon. So this pi electron will be shifted to this position. A negative charge develops on this oxygen and this carbon gets a positive charge. This positive charge indicates electron deficiency in carbon. So this bond is broken heterolytically. These two electrons will be shifted to this position to make a double bond here. This hydrogen gets positive charge and H plus will be attached to this negatively charged oxygen. So as a result, listen here what is happening. CH2 single bond, C, H no change, it becomes a single bond, and O, this hydrogen H plus will come to this O minus to form OH, and there will be the formation of a new double bond here. In this compound, CHO is the functional group and this carbon is alpha carbon, which is directly attached to functional group. This carbon contains three hydrogen atoms, that is three alpha hydrogen atoms are there. Okay, this alpha hydrogen will go towards this oxygen by breaking this bond with carbon and making the bond with oxygen. Normally, keto form is more stable than enol form. C double bond O is more stronger than C double bond C. C double bond or carbon oxygen double bond is more powerful than carbon carbon double bond. That is why this will be more stable. So keto form is normally more stable than enol form. The question is to find out the intermediate in acidic hydration of acetylene. This is an important reaction of acetylene. IUPAC name is ethyne and common name is acetylene. Okay. The formation of acetaldehyde is the result of acidic hydration of acetylene with 1% HgSO4 and 40% H2SO4. Listen here, this is a hydration process. Hydration is nothing but addition of water. Here H2O is not given, but you can understand 1% plus 40% means 41%. 59% will be the water. That is very clear by giving the percentage of two acids. Okay, so water is not given separately here. Now, what will be the intermediate? Listen here, CH triple bond CH. One bond is broken and one hydrogen comes here, one OH comes here normally. Firstly, this is converted into this one. This compound is nothing but CH2 double bond CHOH. CHOH. Two carbon atoms are there, so ether double bond is present, so en, then OH is present, ol, so the intermediate is ethenol. Ethenol is nothing but enol form. Enol form is less stable, so what happens here, this is converted into keto form. How is converted into keto form? The CH2 becomes CH3, H comes here and double bond becomes single bond, then CH, here a double bond comes with the oxygen. This is nothing but this one, that is acetaldehyde. So, enol formation takes place in the reaction of acetylene with 1% HgSO4 and 40% H2SO4 for the formation of acetaldehyde. How acetaldehyde is formed? As a result of tautomerization. Okay? We can check all these compounds one by one. The first compound is this. Listen here, there's a functional group C double bond O. This is alpha carbon and this is alpha carbon. But in this case, there is no alpha hydrogen. But in this alpha carbon, there are two alpha hydrogen atoms are present. So this compound shows tautomerism. This compound does not show tautomerism because this is alpha carbon, this is alpha carbon. Why these are alpha carbon? These carbon atoms are directly attached to this functional group C double bond O. There is no hydrogen present in these two alpha carbon atoms. So this does not show tautomerism. This is the second compound. Now, this is a third compound. In this compound, this is alpha carbon. This is also alpha carbon, singly bonded, sp3 carbon. So, acidic hydrogen is present. But this compound is bridged. Both the alpha carbon atoms are bridged carbon atoms. That is why this does not show tautomerism. Now, in this compound, this the fourth compound, listen here. This is alpha, this is alpha, this is alpha, this is alpha. There is hydrogen atom also. Alpha hydrogen is present. But each alpha carbon atoms are sp2 carbon. The condition for showing tautomerism is the presence of sp3 carbon. In this case, alpha carbon atoms are sp2 carbon atoms. That is why this compound also does not show tautomerism. Now we can check the first compound. This compound is an example for enol. Why this is an example for enol? There is a double bond and one OH is present on that doubly bonded carbon. Okay, if this compound is in enol form, then by changing the position of this hydrogen into this carbon, double bond comes here. This is keto form. So in this case, tautomerism is possible. The given compound is enol form. This is its keto form. So this compound shows tautomerism. We have discussed already this compound. This is very important. This alpha, 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 alpha. Alpha carbon atoms are sp2 carbon. That is why this does not show tautomerism. In this case, listen here. One C double bond O here. So this is alpha carbon. This is also one double bond C double bond O. So this is alpha carbon. This compound shows tautomerism in two different places. So this shows tautomerism. This is a question with more than one correct answer. A and C are the answers. How many sigma and pi bonds are present in tautomer of acetone? Okay. The formula of acetone is nothing but CH3 single bond C double bond O CH3. There is the functional group, that is C double bond O. The carbon is directly attached to this carbon and this carbon. Both the carbon atoms are alpha carbon. There are 6 alpha hydrogen atoms are present. Definitely this compound shows tautomerism. How can we write the tautomer of acetone? H goes from here, double bond comes here, double bond goes from here, and H comes here. Okay, so this is the tautomer CH2, double bond C, single bond O, single bond H, here as it is, CH3 as it is. Okay, firstly we can count the number of sigma bonds. Here one hydrogen and two hydrogen, that is 3 hydrogen atoms. So 3 sigma bond. Carbon-carbon, one sigma bond, that is 4th one. Carbon-oxygen, one sigma bond, 5th one. Carbon-carbon, next 6th one. Then carbon-hydrogen, so 3 hydrogen atoms are there. So total number sigma is equal to 9. Pi bond is equal to 1. Okay, we have discussed already the calculation of sigma and pi bonds in another video. Search for that. In this compound, listen here, 2 hydrogen atoms. 2 sigma bonds, here 3 sigma bonds, 4 sigma bond, 5 sigma bond, 6 sigma bond, and 3, that is 9 sigma bond. Sigma is equal to 9, 1 pi bond, pi is equal to 1. Okay, from this question, you should understand a fact that no change in sigma and pi bonds in case of tautomers. In tautomers, there is no change in sigma and pi bonds. That is a fact you should learn. This compound is phenol. This is enol form. Enol form. Double bond and OH. So, what is the keto form of this compound? We can write this cyclohexane ring. No change for this double bond. No change for this double bond. But what happens? Double bond comes here with oxygen and hydrogen comes with this carbon. Okay? From here, double bond goes. Double bond comes here. So double bond came here. H goes from here to this alpha carbon. Okay? So hydrogen comes here. This is the keto form of phenol. Definitely, this is more stable. Why phenol is more stable? This is a completely conjugated system. In this compound, conjugation maximum. Maximum conjugation. Okay, this is a conjugated system with a full resonance. That is why phenol is more stable than its keto form. Now we can check this one. What's the name of this compound? Butan 2-one. This is alpha carbon. This is also alpha carbon. From which carbon hydrogen will go? Tertiary hydrogen is more acidic than secondary hydrogen, which is more acidic than primary hydrogen. This hydrogen is primary hydrogen. This as alpha hydrogen is secondary hydrogen. So if there is the presence of secondary hydrogen, definitely that will participate in tautomerization. Are you okay? Here what will happen? From this carbon, hydrogen will go and a double bond comes here. This is the enol form of this compound. Double bond can be come here, but more possibility is in between these two carbon atoms. Why? This is the secondary alpha carbon. Keto form is more stable than enol form. Why? Carbon oxygen double bond is more stronger than carbon carbon double bond. Now we can discuss about acetyl acetone and its tautomer and their stability. This is acetyl group. Acetyl group is attached to acetone. That is why this is acetyl acetone, which is a diketone. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbon atoms, so pent. All the carbon atoms are connected by single bond, so pentane. Then second and fourth carbon, there is ketone. That is why pentane, 2, 4, dione. That is IUPAC name of acetyl acetone. Here I have given the bond line notation of acetyl acetone. Now listen here. This is secondary alpha carbon. This is alpha, this is alpha, this is alpha. But this is primary and this is primary. This is secondary. So hydrogen will be shifted from this carbon because that is more acidic. Always you should understand the alpha carbon present between two CO groups. That alpha carbon carries the hydrogen with the maximum acidity. Okay. Now I am giving the tautomer of acetyl acetone. Listen here. There is no change for carbon chain. Hydrogen goes from here, double bond comes here, double bond goes from here, hydrogen comes here. There is no change for this C double bond O. This form is keto form and this form is enol form. After the formation of enol form, there is a possibility of intramolecular hydrogen bond between this oxygen and this hydrogen. Can you see? Intramolecular hydrogen bond between this oxygen and this hydrogen. So as a result of intramolecular hydrogen bond, enol form will not convert into keto form. Enol form will be extra stable than this keto form because of this possibility. Okay, what's the reason behind that one? Nothing but intramolecular hydrogen bond. Intramolecular H bond. Hydrogen bond. We have already discussed about this one. That is keto-enol tautomerism. This one is cyanide-isocyanide tautomerism. Cyanide-isocyanide. This is a simple compound, you know. You should understand this shows tautomerism. Why? Isocyanide can be formed here. So hydrogen will be shifted from this carbon to this nitrogen. This compound also shows tautomerism. This show two types of tautomerisms. First one is nitro-nitrite. Second one is nitro-acy. Two types of tautomerism are shown by this one. This is amide group. This compound, the compounds containing amide group show amido-imidol tautomerism. Amido-imidol tautomerism. One form is amide form, the second form is imidol form. The tautomerism. Okay. An important compound containing this one is nothing but urea, which is a previous question. Urea shows tautomerism because urea shows amido-imidol tautomerism. What is the importance of urea? Urea is the first organic substance synthesized in the laboratory. Frederick Wohler, who is the father of organic chemistry, synthesized urea from ammonium cyanate. That preparation made the world of organic chemistry. The formula of urea is nothing but NH2CONH2. This compound shows tautomerism because alpha carbon, which is sp3 carbon, and alpha hydrogen atoms are present here. Also a secondary alpha carbon and hydrogen atoms are present. This is also alpha carbon and alpha hydrogen atoms are present here. Alpha carbon is present but no alpha hydrogen, so this will not show ketoenol tautomerism. So there is no need of examining this compound for maximum enol content. What is the meaning of maximum enol content? That is, for which compound enol form is more stable than keto form, that we have already discussed in this case. Because enol form is more stable means maximum enol content will be formed from this keto form. Are you okay? As compared to these two compounds. So the answer is this one. B is the correct answer.